So, last week, or last time on the Hidden Knife, our adventurers had headed off into the southern Orklands on a variety of quests. Some seek 20 years that have been stolen from a fox in Excare. Others seek something hidden in a vault somewhere deeper in the Orklands. But along the way, as they journeyed north with their half-orc ally Anvar, they came across a accosted hill dwarf. A hill dwarf being accosted by a number of orcs leaping into battle. Our stalwart heroes managed to save Benegrim's sweetbread. Hill dwarf, pastry maker, candy connoisseur. And after much deliberation, sent him back to Fexcare, but not before with Anvar, but not before Tristan shared some of his poetry with Anvar in an attempt to help the half-orc woo the lovely vixen. Or, as Benegrim understood it, maybe to woo Anvar himself. But in the morning, the two left, and the rest of the group headed north. And as we left off last time, as I remember, you guys were headed down the ridge towards the valley that kind of butts up against the wildwood, kind of framed by the Feldir River, the Steplands to the north, and you saw, as you headed down, a small cottage, and coming out of the cottage, heading towards a small flock of sheep, is a young woman about your age, and that's where we'll start.
All right. Is this about the place where the fox bone setter, whose name I am spacing out on, is this about the place where he told us we would find
Yes.
Okay. All right. Before we do anything else, all of you, I would like to briefly take a moment to meditate.
Okay.
Tristan is going to say, now, I've been briefed on witches. And if there's anything that I know about them, it's that you can never trust that things are what they seem to be. So I'm just going to very quickly try to achieve, I don't want to bore you with the details, but it's sort of a higher state of mind, actually.
Okay.
And, well, we could talk to her.
Yeah, that's what I was...
We don't want to talk to her until we're ready to talk to her.
Buy a clam?
What?
Dinner?
That's fine, but she may be able to read our thoughts. She may be able to cast a spell on one of us.
And or see us, since we can see her.
Right.
I'm just wondering about that.
Meant to meditate.
Well...
I'm going to cast Psycho Stabilis on myself.
Okay.
All right, that's pretty good.
Yes, it is.
So that's a quality level 3. So I believe that for the duration of the spell, make sure I'm doing this right. Cards are all out of order. I believe that for the duration of the spell, my spirit is increased.
Quality
is it by one?
By two, so it'll you round up.
Okay. So my total spirit is now 4.
Right. Excellent.
All right. So just Tristan just takes a moment to kind of center himself. Preparing for the great battle of magics, which is about to ensue.
Okay. At this point, the young lady who has exited the cabin has kind of made it to where the sheep are pastured, but is now kind of looking up the hill in your direction.
I think this means that the young lady is pretty, because anytime that Tristan sees a young lady, he's like, witch!
That's not true. No, actually at all.
Vigo last waves.
Hello!
He's like, hello! Myself.
Thorwolf waves as well.
That's what you just did.
No, it's because I... never mind. All right. Yes. Delilah, you're good at talking to people, so...
All right. So Delilah's going to go down the hill and meet the young woman.
Scooch and Bennett, okay.
Wiggleas follows because he likes sheep. They are fluffy and he knows how to hug them. Yeah. Also, the other things that you do with sheep.
No!
All right.
He's a furry.
You can see the young woman has kind of picked up the shepherd's crook and has started to head towards you. There's a small stone bridge that crosses the Fell Deer here. It's not a very wide river at this point, but that seems to be where she's headed to.
Okay.
Tristan, are we going with them, or are we just going to let Vigolas go down there and talk about
sheep? Oh, no, we're definitely going with them. They're not equipped to deal with this.
With the witch.
Hello! Hello!
Especially that one. He's especially not equipped.
Hello!
Yeah, Tristan and Thorwolf will head on down as well.
All right.
Ellen Wake goes too. All
right.
Yeah, we're going. All
right. Yeah, we're all going, but yeah, I'm trying to let Delilah do the talking.
Yeah, Delilah's talking.
She waves to you. Hello? Hello? Are you lost?
No!
No, we're not lost. We're looking for someone.
Well, you have found someone. Unless you're looking for an orc, they tend to live out that way.
We're looking for the Witch of the Wood.
Her eyes kind of get very big, and she kind of grabs onto the shepherd's crook a little bit. Why would you seek out the Witch of the Woods?
We had some business with her.
If it's a pejorative, we're very sorry.
Also, the word...
pejorative.
Pejorative.
If it's not you, we're also very sorry, because... that would be very rude.
Oh, I'm...
Hi, I'm Delilah.
Hi. Greetings, Delilah. I am Puera.
I'm Vigolas.
What did she say her name was?
Puera.
How do you spell that?
P-U-E-R-A. Sorry, I keep. If I look like this, it's because I've got a different screen up and I'm looking at you guys.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Because it's ease of keys.
Right, so you seek the Witch of the Woods. That is either very brave or very foolish.
We get those mixed up.
You're essentially looking at a lot of very brave and very foolish people.
Not me, I'm just foolish.
Oh, you say you sell yourself short, Thorwolf. You're both brave and very foolish. No.
Do you know where we might find her?
She kind of looks back over her shoulder. In the woods, but most people who go in there to find her don't ever come back out. They say they get lost. Those who do come back with a different sense of time. They don't know how long they were in there. They don't know how long, what
so
day it
Puera,
is. Yes.
Is it just you out here by yourself with a bunch of sheep?
Yeah.
Oh no! Oh no! My father Sati, he comes through here. This is his house. I tend his sheep while he's off trading.
Oh, where does he trade?
Sometimes he goes down into Fex Care, sometimes further along. Very rarely he trades with the Guranzai tribe. As far as orcs go, they're almost peaceful.
And he just leaves you out here by yourself in the middle of the orc lands.
Well, it's where I grew up. And
we hail from Fex Care. What is his name? Maybe we've met him on his trading.
Saki?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sure you wouldn't. He wouldn't deal with such fine people as yourself. He tends to deal mostly with like Marinites. Sometimes he speaks with followers of Fex.
I'm a blessed of Perrain. I would probably met him.
Excellent. I have one of my sheep. He keeps coughing something up. Can you help me?
Yes.
Well, can I offer you something to eat? Lunch, perhaps? Break your fast today.
Yes to both. Eating, then sheep.
That is a good call. And she leads you back to the little cottage. It's a small stone cottage. You can see a little bit of a smoke curling from the chimney. It definitely looks like about two people live here. There are only three chairs, two plates that have been set out. Something is cooking in the kettle that swings over into the stove. There's stairs that head up into the second floor. And Puera just goes about pulling down some simple fare, salted meat, and...
Tristan is very conscious of the fact that there are six of us, and that's a lot of people to feed. And so he is, I guess, going to offer some of our provisions to sort of add to the table.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Well, do you mind grabbing some of the logs from outside for stools? I don't have... Again, we just have the three.
Of course not. Thorwolf, would you help?
Right.
And somebody should tend to the mules. I'll do that as well.
You don't have to. I certainly don't mind. I was actually thinking of naming the mules. you know, but that's all right. You go ahead. You go ahead. You probably haven't had as much experience with animals being a sailor, so this will be good for you.
True. Yes. And he very quietly leaves the cottage. It's a strange man you brought with you. He walks as if the earth is constantly moving.
Concussions and strong drink will do that after a while, I'm given to understand.
Also
sea legs.
I did know that.
With you, we can never.
Well, very quickly, you guys set out your the fare that you provide and what Puera sets down. And so you... You head into the woods, then. I would...
Yes. One of the gentlemen in the town indicated that he...
Nope. No.
What?
He lost something. At the witch. With the witch. To the witch.
To the witch.
Oh, to the witch. I've heard tales of this.
Indeed. So we've been asked to
try to get it back.
Have a word with her and see if we can convince her to return what he's lost.
It's a baby.
It's not a baby. It's don't.
We have some disagreements on what exactly was lost.
My friend we lost here has what do you call it? his
Optimism. I have optimism.
No, I was going to say your biological clock is ticking down. But
you want the baby?
You
no, what?
You're trying to
my mother.
You're trying to take a baby from the witch in the woods?
The witch you know, don't worry about, there's no babies.
I'm very regular. I like biological clock is quite fine, thank you, Tristan. I appreciate your concern, however.
We're just learning new things about you every day.
All right. Well, so, I mean, that seems like an awful long way to come into the Orklands, but I would say, my father has always said that in the Wildwoods, stay on the path. Bring nothing in that would harm the witch. For the most part, that's why Sati leaves me here, because the orcs are scared of her. Something happened a while ago, and the orcs don't come near this place anymore. So he says we're safe.
What happened a while ago?
He didn't really say. One of the orc chieftains went missing in the wood, but he won't speak more of it than that.
Can I make an empathy test to just see if she's holding anything back, if she's telling us straight?
Sure.
Because
it's
Because I'm so stinking good at empathy.
Could Delilah do that?
Empathy is my dump stat, but I still made it, so quality level one.
You can also empathize.
I have empathies.
You do have empathies?
I have empathies. So, yeah, I got a quality level one.
Can I do a myth and legends to see if I know what happened?
You give me a myth and legends roll. Yeah, that'll work. Because it's such a specific roll, it'll be at -2. Oh, and don't forget, guys, you all get one fate point back at the start of the session.
Yep. Oh, cool. Tristan is also very good at myths and legends.
Well, you're currently empathizing.
Well, he's also good at multitasking.
Let me get through this real quick.
Yeah, that's fine.
All right, you had quality level one. What did you get?
Let me figure it out. Let me see.
But way the heck off.
Wait, it's number two, right? It's two under that, so I can't.
Five.
And yeah, so you're rolling
that. That makes it.
And right, so your sagacity, two under is nine.
Yeah,
so.
I don't make it.
Okay, that's all right. I'm very good.
It was a great roll.
I'm very good at
missed it by one.
Dang, that's a first for Delilah, I think.
Missed it by one, charisma.
Do you have 8 points? I don't know if we want to spend them on this, but that's all right.
You got a quality level one.
I did.
She definitely, Puera definitely seems to be feeling, she's definitely guarded. You don't know whether it's because she's definitely trying to hide something or because there are six strangers sitting in her lonely cottage.
That's fair.
But she's definitely not being, she's being guarded.
All right. And can I try the Myths and Legends thing?
Sure. Well, and what was your name again, Blessed One?
Vigolas. I am Vigolas. I have a last name, which escapes me because it's been such a long time since anybody asked.
Well, Your Grace, would you mind tending to the sheep?
Yes, certainly. I mean, yes. sheep! Where are the sheep?
I will show you.
Alright. I got a at a -2 on the roll, I got a quality level one on Myths and Legends.
Okay. You don't have anything, nothing of the myths or legends comes to mind, but it does trigger from what Oakward told you. You remember Oakward said that there was a company of orcs that was massing the night, like to the north, the night that he went into the woods. And when he returned, not only was he older, but the orcs were gone.
Got it.
Hmm. All right. Hey, Vigalos.
Yes, sir.
You want to give me a sheeping roll?
Animal roll?
Yep.
A sheeping?
A sheeping roll. Well, while Vigalos is out sheeping, what are the rest of you doing? Thorwulf at this point returns with stools. His hands kind of look a little raw. He's got a little bit of a nip in one of his fingers.
Everything all right, Thor?
It's mule.
They're tricky.
Did it bite you?
It did. It did miss, Takani.
Quality level 4.
You very quickly identify that, what is wrong with the sheep. And it's really just a matter of something they're ingesting. You're able to find a little bit, a couple of really pungent weeds that have started to grow up around the area. It takes you about a half hour, and during that time, what are the rest of you guys doing? You're kind of in this cottage by yourself. You can see the woods looming off in the distance, even though the sun has kind of poked through the clouds and the rain has just been reduced to a drizzle. The trees are thick enough that the sunlight doesn't seem to penetrate through the canopy of the trees.
Okay, Takani's probably helping bring in logs, and then she's going to start whittling, because that's what she would do.
Delilah is going to, without touching or moving or prying, look around the room and see if there's anything that seems like it would disagree with the girl's story.
Okay, give me a perception roll. Alanwe, Tristan, what are you doing?
Alanwe, would you step outside with me for a moment?
Sure.
All right.
Now, I know that I studied a little bit of elven magic when I was at the Gareth Academy of Sword and Staff. And I...
All right, everybody drink.
Registered trademark.
It's going to be a thing now. That's fair. I know that some elves have the ability to see through things, see through enchantments, see through walls, and that some also have the ability to see very keenly a long way off, or perhaps to see through the eyes of an eagle, through the eyes of a hawk. The thing about witches is that they don't... Most of their powers are not... they're not so much things like what I do. Most of the things I do are things that the witch could learn. But they tend to be abilities of transformation, abilities of disguise, the abilities to plant suggestions in the mind. So I don't know what all you're capable of. I know we've only recently met. But if you have anything like that, I'll just sort of point off towards the wood and say... the first thing that we've been told is to stay on the path, but if there is anything that I have learned, it is that paths, whether they're real paths or you realize I'm being metaphorical here, metaphorical paths, are often misleading, and sometimes what looks like it might be the path isn't really. So anyway, if you're able to see through metaphorical paths. I think it would be most useful. I will do my best, but I was really trained more as a sort of a regimental mage. Mm-hmm. So I'm not going to be as good in this sort of thing.
Yes. We'll see what I can see.
There's a horrible gagging noise in the sheep. Fold.
Man, I hope that's the sheep.
It's the sheep. I got it! Also, none of these sheep are witches!
What did you get, Delilah?
Quality level 3.
Quality level 3? Awesome.
even if Ben will get his crap on me.
So, as you look around, you can see all of the trappings of country life. You know, dry meats, homemade cheeses, vegetables in their place. Spices, but what you do notice is there's a lot more herbs, like dried herbs in pots kind of along the shelves than you... I mean, you're not really from the country, you know, as Delilah being raised in where she was raised. So, yeah, it just stands out a little bit to you. Meanwhile, Thorwolf looks over at Takani, whittling. You do animals?
He shows him it's a wolf.
Ah.
It's a wolf head.
Nice. Reminds me of Alphir. She
Awesome.
Yeah.
In what way?
Oh, just the lines, the lifelike quality.
Are you saying she looks like this, or that she was able to do this as well?
Oh no, she didn't look anything like that. She was quite a lady.
Everything reminds me.
All right, what are Tristan and Alanwe doing?
Alanwe is trying to find her spells. keep going.
Sorry.
Is Fuera out there at the sheepfold with Vigolas?
Yeah, she's still out there with you.
Okay.
Kind of so, as you get down to deal with some of this, she's down there helping you.
Excellent. So, Vera, make sure that they don't eat any more of this and that you give them something else that is not this.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Your Grace. You are definitely filled with the wisdom of Perrain. I would not have known that.
Perrain hugs us all to her great, warm, swelling bosoms.
What?
She loves all of her creations.
I must ask, Your Grace, why are you... She kind of puts her hand on your shoulder while you're down there pulling these weeds. Why are you out here? Why are you not in some town or temple dealing with your flock?
Well, my purpose is twofold. First, I am here to assist Tristan Foxfur in his grand endeavors in the Orklands. I assume. Secondly, I wish to see the world. I am going to buy a bestiary someday, which will include all sorts of creatures, which are not sheep, because I can tell you from experience, they have many books on sheep.
The literature on sheep is fully covered.
It is... Very, very exhaustive.
Interesting. Well, don't get lost in the woods, Your Grace. It can be a dark and strange place.
Thank you, Fer. We'll be very careful. We have an elf, and we have a mage, and we have a Northlander, and we have a dancer. So, between all of us, we should be okay.
Tristan is going to, as Ellenway is surveying the countryside,
so, thinking. I have this. Eli. This raises my
raises your perception. Yeah. Well, that's
and then bad. I have this, which allows me to perceive magic.
Use that on the girl. Use it on the cottage. Use it on everything.
Use it on the
quote, on everything.
Tristan is going to head back inside and just ask Delilah. So you're clever. Have you noticed anything?
She seems to be really into herbs, but I don't know if that's normal for out here. But and she'll Delilah's gonna gesture to the shelf of herbs.
Can Tristan, given that Tristan is a fairly well trained alchemist, can he sort of look over the herbs and see if there are combinations thereof which seem significant?
Sure.
Delilah is going to start preparing food.
All right. Puera comes back in and washes her arms off. Your blessed one is quite strange.
Yeah, you know.
He's very friendly. He's very friendly.
Quality level 3 on alchemy.
All right.
Okay.
All right. Food is made. You don't see anything that necessarily stands out in combination that may be strange, Tristan. I mean, you see some thrash beard, you see some Yoruga, which is kind of it prevents a number of like febrile diseases. You do see some of the same berries that you picked in the forest last time.
Yes.
All right, but there's nothing. That looks,
what was that?
Yeah, there's nothing that looks like she's been brewing like, you know, magical potions or things like that.
No, not at this point. No.
Okay. All right.
What did you get, Alanwe? What spell are you casting?
This one?
Casting, yeah, the Odin.
Odin Arcana?
Arcane.
Okay, what did you get? What quality level did you get?
She missed it by one.
Oh, okay.
Which
one? I tried to concentrate really hard and nothing happened. Which dice didn't make it?
Well.
Which one did you fail on?
There's a 20.
20.
Right, but
she spent
3 different skills.
Oh,
intellect.
Which skill?
Intellect.
That's actually intuition.
Intuition. Okay. She failed on intuition, but she also failed on, well, not like, she, yes, intuition. Okay.
People are strange.
There's a lot strange going on along the way, and while you're normally very in tune with your surroundings, it just all feels off. You're in the Orklands, you're not, I mean, everything that happened with your brother is still kind of weighing fairly heavily on your on your mind. So, yeah, you don't really see anything. The spell doesn't seem to take. Nothing stands out as magical.
Okay.
Thank you very much for your help and for your wise questions. I think we've got to make our way into the wood now, but if there's anything that we can do to repay your hospitality, I would be most eager to do so.
Your blessed one has helped my sheep. You provided me with more food than I know what to do with at this point, and you have been gracious guests, and I enjoyed spending time with you. If you survive the wood, please come back through here. We will, Father and I will put you up for the evening. I would.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You better make a little extra room in your hayloft for Wigolas in that case. He has a tendency to spread out. we will see you again soon.
Excuse me, did you say there was something that we should not take into the woods?
The witch reacts very poorly to, according to the stories, to any overt threats, and the woods are her domain, so taking things in there that could harm her.
What kind of things would harm her?
I don't know. The stories are vague. But she does look at Thorwolf and Takani.
And Takani...
And kind of just glosses over Vigalas.
Like, I'm not leaving my stuff out here. No!
It's okay. We will have the dancer go first.
Delilah shifts her bag uncomfortably and takes the lead. Uncomfortably. Emphasis.
So once we're...
I'm not comfortable with it. Takani kind of holds her sword really close to her. It's not...
Once we're clear
of
the cottage.
She's kind of shaking the bag a little bit, you know, to make sure everything's nice and
shifted.
What is happening? What is happening?
She's carrying a backpack. It's on her back.
Wow. That was amazing.
All
but
right.
You know what? If her shifting of stuff in her backpack looks like dancing, that makes sense.
All right.
Whatever.
All right. So,
the late morning is cool. The rain is drizzling down. Not much more than just a mist. There's a little bit of mist rising off of the valley floor as you head towards the forest.
I have a very bad feeling that she was trying to tell us we should leave our weapons behind us.
Are you?
I'm not suggesting that we do that. What I am suggesting is that perhaps a couple of the less threatening members of the party go on a little bit ahead. At least once we get in sight of the witch's home, if she has a home. I assume she's still at home.
You are wearing beautiful white robes. And have a stick. You should go first. No. I am Vigolas, the blessed one of Perrin, and I have a cudgel from a very fine cudgelry on Main Street.
He's very scary.
And I am a dangerous man.
Are you saying I should leave the saber behind?
There's too much in there to deal with all at once.
But my suggestion would be that elves are creatures of the wild, and creatures, I didn't mean that to sound like it did, but you know what I mean. You're sort of
what
on
did you mean?
terms with magical things. You understand?
Yes.
And Delilah, I think that perhaps if we just maybe put the saber under something... you would be non-threatening and perhaps very friendly to the witch. And,
Or keep on your head.
And perhaps... that's not Vigalas. Because as you say, you are a very dangerous man. And I feel like the cudgel would intimidate the witch. So perhaps Delilah and Ellenway and myself... should go ahead, and then the three of you dangerous individuals.
And when I get here, and it is a baby, we will carry the take back to the Temple of Perrin, and maybe they will have a feast. But probably they will spend it.
Right. Of course. Right. So I think we'll just proceed on in this way then. And if you can keep an eye out for magical things...
Yes, I shall.
Can she do that one thing again? The same.
The Odom
Arcana. Try that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's the duration on that spell? That's an arcane term.
Duration.
It lasts 1 minute.
Arcane.
It is.
Okay.
I'm sort of an expert, so I'm just good for this.
He went to school for this.
If you are so glad you're here.
Okay. I'm glad you're here too, Takani.
Okay, blue is first. Oh, shoot.
You need to retire that red. Okay, is that a 19?
Yes.
Holy,
yes.
What?
19 and 20.
Okay, never
Why
mind
I
that.
Why do I get rolls like this?
It's okay. It happens to the
is
best
it worth
of us.
Re-rolling with a... She doesn't have another one. Oh, do you?
Do you started the session with one?
Yeah, she used it. Last time she tried this.
You didn't have another one?
Maybe
she
I have
three total, right?
She has two total because she is unlucky every week.
Oh, thank you.
Dang it!
Oh. No, that's her actual...
I know! It's not supposed to work like that!
Alright, so that's all you have. You have one left?
Yeah.
Do you want to use it now? I don't know. Maybe use it to reroll that 19 and 20.
Okay.
Maybe use some different dice.
What was this one? Is that 8?
Yeah. That was an 8.
Do you think it's rolling the dice?
I'll take my dice back.
These guys have come up like 20s twice, so yes.
Nope, it's just your luck.
All right, so an 11 and a 17. Which one is the 17?
Oh, that one. We may actually can. That,
yeah, you have to name it.
We could call that the third one. Intuition is 15.
So you only need 2 to buy it down.
So I have 3. And so
you
have
3.
5, so it's still at right. A quality
so you,
level 1?
Yep.
Quality hey. Level 1.
What's up?
It was a group effort, really.
All right. You can see that as your senses open to the arcane energy flowing through the woods, the first thing you notice is that everything ahead of you is slightly tinged red. There is magic present, not just localized in the wood, but the wood itself seems imbued with magic. Even as you can kind of see how it's the arcanum kind of spreads out from the edge of the forest, slowly seeping into the ground. Yeah, Tristan shows up, a little magical.
What? What'd you see?
He has an aura. It appears the whole wood is magic.
Oh, yeah. So just everything is magical.
Yeah. Well, he's
been does the path look true?
The path through the forest, at least the small entrance that you saw leaving Puera's house, which really has the site of a formerly well-used path that has overgrown for the last decade or so. Even the trees kind of forms an arch where this path heads into the forest. That does not seem, that actually seems quite mundane. And actually the spread of the glow from the forest does not seem to affect the path at all.
So, that's true.
Right. Forward? Forward?
Yeah. Forward. I think that means that we let the squishy people go first.
All right, so I have...
Tristan. It means
Alanway and Delilah up first, and then following
it means,
behind the wolf, Vigalas, and Tani. Alright, I'd like everyone to give me perception rolls as you head into the forest.
Everyone what?
Make what rolls?
Perception rolls.
Excellent. I'm so good at this.
For those of you who, while they do this, the coupon for Petri's Family Games is now live. So, again, thank you to Cam for that. And I hope you guys get some good gaming stuff out of it.
Cool. Okay, I'm actually pretty good at that.
Okay, so for perception. Quality level 4?
Quality level 1. My dice are hot tonight.
The last one you get?
I got a 20 on my, what was it, perception again? Sagacity. So
sagacity.
Sagacity, utter failure. And then I got a 1 on my, what is keep losing it. On my intelligence.
Intuition,
excuse me. So,
no.
Yeah. Nailed it. I have no other, I can't buy up any points. So.
Yeah. All right. Takani?
I have a good roll. Let me figure it out. I have a quality level. No, it's just a 2. I have a quality level 2. We both have quality level 2s.
All right. Very quickly, as you head into the forest, there is you realize that the light dims a bit as you expected, but it doesn't quite ever disappear. It takes you a while to realize, though, that it's not the light that's coming through the canopy that is lighting your path. Although you can see golden green shafts of the light that break through the leaves and spears throughout your vision. But there is an ambient glow to the forest. The mist has a soft luminescent quality to it, and kind of rising out of the mist are these phosphorescent motes that just seem to spread out. Some of them drift near. They never get close enough to actually reach out and grab. But they provide much of the light as you travel this path into the forest. Tristan,
are they alive? The little motes, can we tell if they're alive?
You cannot, Vigalos. You are aware of the trees at this point with your...
They're so big!
They're so big! Tristan, that's also what you see. Alanwe and Takani, you and Delilah, you also see that as people start to move closer towards these moats, they do seem to actively move away from you. The mist swirls and eddies around your feet. The path, if you're not careful, does seem to... The mist wants to cover the path, so there are times where you have to stop and wait for it to clear, or clear it yourself, to make sure you're not moving off the path. Delilah, you definitely get the sense that there is a presence in the forest, and it is trying to get you off the path. There are a couple of times where you actually go to take a step, and there's a jolt that runs from your hip all the way down to your foot right before you step, and you'll see the mist kind of clear away, and it would be off the path. You also hear the sound of water falling, tinkling just off in the distance, and it seems to be growing louder as you move deeper into this wood.
She lived by water, didn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Is that... Nope. Yeah.
All of you also notice every now and again dark shapes darting from tree to tree above you.
Nice.
Small ones.
What kind of dark shapes?
They're not like giant flying eyeballs with bats or bat wings, are they?
No.
Weird monkey.
No,
like squirrels.
Delilah, they are squirrels, and with a quality level 4, you actually recognize them. They're adorable gray little squirrels with a spiral horn that comes out of the top of right behind their eyes.
Squirrel.
You know them. The Svelte River Valley used to call them death squirrels.
Wait, what? Who called them death squirrels?
The Svelte River folk that's kind of in this area. They're known as death squirrels.
Why? Because they have horns.
Because they have large horns on their head. And they hunt by plunging daringly from tree onto unsuspecting victims.
I told you.
Sheriff.
I told you.
Share with us this information. So, those things that... I don't think horns are normal on squirrels.
No, they are not.
Her shield holds up like an umbrella. but they definitely have horns.
It is probably the greater northern death squirrel.
Do tell us the differences between the Greater Northern Death Squirrel.
It's mostly about the horns.
One of them curls this way, and the other one curls that way.
Exactly, it's funny. In different directions, depending on where you are, at the length of it, That would be lovely, Tikani. If perhaps one crosses the path, I wouldn't want to put you in danger. Perrain would not be pleased if you were harmed while trying to capture a death squirrel.
Could you tell Tikani a bit more about the squirrels? I think she was really enjoying that.
Certainly.
You know, with squirrels, and you told him to tell me about.
Friendship is a two-way
street. It's been a while since I've seen the book, which was a very small book about the Death Squirrels. I'm given to understand that the author found it very difficult to observe them on account of them being Death Squirrels.
Are very cute.
While you are describing the Death Squirrels, I'm going to need a dodge roll from you as one of them jumps out of the trees coming straight towards you.
Can I catch it?
Who's it coming at? It's coming at Vigalos?
It is diving directly at Vigalos. You can give me a parry roll, Takati.
You always want to interrupt his actions.
I do.
Like, constantly. Like.
Can I catch it?
You can attempt to.
Is that a body control?
No, that's just a parry roll.
Alright, and dodge is that also body control, or is that action?
Parry with your brawling skill. So your brawling is 8.
What did I say?
Yep.
Oh, you know,
your
I think
parry with
my
brawling is 8.
Combat stage. Dang it.
So you need 8 or less.
Dang it.
Are you missing your combat
page? I'm missing my combat page.
Is it... Do you have it to print off?
Probably somewhere, but...
What's this about being character sheets?
I didn't catch it. If it's
Takami
my
did not catch
falling.
It, and Ben has lost his...
Okay.
Agility
dodge.
Divided by 2 is your dodge.
Okay, so it's agility by 2, so just a 1...
7.
So 1d12?
Yep, 1d20.
1d20, right, excuse me. 13, and so I can't buy that off, right?
You can spend a fate point to reroll it if you like.
Okay, so I'm targeting a 7, so... Yeah, let me do that. Right, rolling again. This time it was a 20! Zook!
A natural 20.
A natural 20.
So you can't reroll that.
Do you have to take the new roll, or can you choose the better of
the
two?
Roll.
Gosh darn it. So you just critically failed dodging a death squirrel.
While describing it.
They're beautiful, noble creatures. Their horns are full of
monkeys.
Oh, very painful squirrels.
Hey, Ben, do you have a Vigalos? Do you have any armor?
They're not cute. They are not. Someone get it off.
Vigalos, do you have any armor?
Now can I get it?
I still need to know if you have armor, Ben.
I do not. No. I do
we
not have armor.
I cannot hear you, Oliver, all the laughing.
Oh,
I have no armor. Am I dead?
Oh,
please be dead.
I do not know if you are dead. However, here's what all of you see. The first, there is this dark shadow that kind of looms in the top of the trees. And a smaller patch of sable kind of just jumps out of this shadow, diving towards Vigalos. And Takani yelling, look out! Throws her shield out, and while she misses, Vigalos definitely looks up. And Vigalos, the death squirrel, comes down and hits you in your left eye for 14 points of damage.
How many?
14.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
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 So Tristan's going to turn around, and does he, like, just legit have a squirrel sticking out of his eye right now?
He has a squirrel that is currently pulling a bloody horn out of the sausage that was Vigalas's left eye.
Holy crap. I've got my staff in hand. I will just expertly swing the butt end of the staff around and knock the squirrel off of his face.
It's a corkscrew.
What? It's already out. He said it was already
out. Oh, it's out?
Is the horn out?
It is.
No. So I'm just gonna knock. I'm gonna knock the squirrel off him if I can.
Go for it.
All right. That hits.
All right. You catch the squirrel right as it's pulling itself free of Vigalas. A damage roll.
Cool. 6 points of damage.
All right. You knock the squirrel. It hits a tree and makes kind of an adorable, cute sound as it then catches itself and starts climbing back up. But that's when you notice the dark shadow breaking apart as more of these things start to descend.
No.
Holy crap. Let's double time it. I'm going to cast Armatruths on myself.
Yeah, me too.
I'm going to need initiative rolls.
Oh, all right.
That's
really
didn't
get you
initiative rolls again?
Holy crap.
Yes!
Okay.
How much
did you get? Like, what do you have left?
13 hit points left.
That's, like, the worst place to get
How much damage did you take? 14 hit points. 14
he
points of damage.
More than half of his hit points.
Yeah.
From a squirrel.
Well, that's not a great initiative roll. I'm going to use a jam.
Yes.
I'm going to use a fate point to go first.
Okay. And then drop back into your normal initiative after that.
Right. So my initiative is 14, but I'm going to use a fate point to go first.
Well,
you roll a d6 and add your initiative modifier.
Possible to print up my combat sheet.
So I rolled a 1 and I have 14.
Right, so your initiative total is 15.
16 for me.
16 for Takani?
Yep.
What did you get along the way?
15.
What did Delilah get?
I don't think she's rolled yet. Neither has Ben.
Sorry.
Vigalas, what did you get? And don't forget your penalty.
I got a
initiative.
4. I'm sorry, my combat sheet is the one page that I forgot. Mm-hmm. I just need to reprint it here real quick.
Okay.
It should be in your email.
Initiative is
D6? It's a D6, yeah.
I got a 1.
A 1 plus your initiative modifier.
No. It should be, I should have said, not recently.
Oh. 16.
All right, Tristan, you were up first, then Delilah and Takani. All right, Tristan, you were up first, sir.
All right, how many squirrels are dropping down around us? It seems like good information.
A lot.
Oh.
Cool. All right, I'm going to cast Armatruths on myself. Let me do that. It's a one action casting time, and I'm going to.
You see about an even dozen that have broken off and are scurrying down the trees towards you.
All right, I'm going to just cast Armatruths on myself to give myself a little extra protection against these blighters. That's all fine. So that's a cruelty level. Quality level 2, so the spell will last for 6 minutes, and I have some extra protection.
All right.
And that's my action.
All right.
I will shout out as a free action, everyone run, but stay on the path.
Run which direction?
Farther in.
Or
deeper in, of course.
Of course. Of course.
I came here to roll dice and make cool decisions, apparently. I mean, metaphorically, little advice.
Right.
You know, like, take chances. Is what I mean.
Gotcha.
Right.
Right.
No, I'm trying.
Delilah and Takani, what are you doing? Tristan's skin starts to harden. Like, on purpose, not on accident. Yeah, or like a spell or something. Like, I'm saying on purpose. What are you guys doing?
Yeah. Delilah is running.
All right.
I'm dodging spells.
All right.
I am, I guess, running since we're all...
You can take the evasion action. Is that right, Jam? That, like, doubles your dodge?
You can.
Am I imagining that?
You are imagining... That's a special ability, I believe.
Oh, okay.
Sounds special.
Could also be just, like, a D&D 5th edition thing, so...
There you go.
You know.
All right, Shekana, you are running?
I want to hit some squirrels.
Hit some squirrels.
I think...
Thorwolf. Oh, I forgot to roll Thorwolf's initiative for you.
I think I want to hit some squirrels.
All right, well then hit some squirrels.
How am I doing that exactly? It's not even like a...
Thorwolf goes on a 17 jam or just whatever.
Wait, D6, not D12. D20.
One second, Takani. Thorwolf suddenly remembers that he gets an action.
Cool. Thorwolf is definitely hitting some squirrels. So, like, he's gonna, like, run, sort of following Tristan, and as the squirrels are coming up, he's just gonna swipe down with his orc nose at one of them.
All right, go for it.
And his orc nose... Thorwolf has such good attacks, and yet he misses.
All right.
Takani's on the other side, doing the same thing with her sword, which is Seal Killer Sword. And I guess I have to hit under that?
No, under your attack setting.
Not combat technique?
No, combat technique is what your is actual technique is. That should have been... Did you recently raise this?
I may have just raised that, but I don't know. Because if that's 12 and that's 13, then that's 16.
And then that's not... I'm not sure. Attack... Your attack rating is your... It is your... The primary ability, right? The
attack rating is based off courage. One for every 3 points above 8.
Okay.
Parry rating is based off primary ability.
So did you pay to raise your courage and your strength? Okay, I see. So every 3 points above 8 gets you to... It's 2. So that makes your attack 17.
Okay.
Which is crazy.
What is a?
You might want to check with James and make sure those numbers are okay later. But
well, I got a 9, so I got it.
All right.
And I do 1d6 plus 4 damage. Can I have that?
All right. Go for it.
6.
All right, Takani, your seal killer lashes out, cuts one of these death squirrels clean in half, and you can see as it dies, its horn crumbles to dust.
Ooh.
It is now the death squirrel's turn.
Wait, are you doing what? As I killed it, the horn crumbled to dust.
The horn or the squirrel?
The horn. The horn.
Vigalos, like Tristan, and Alanwe need to give me dodge rolls.
Who all?
Vigalos, Tristan, and Alanwe.
So, two people running ahead. Which one is dodge?
All right. They're not attacking Thorwolf or Takani?
They missed. Or Takani.
Oh. Say what? Oh, they missed them?
Yes.
All right. I dodge. Surprisingly.
Surprisingly, I do not.
This will be your... You do not...
What do you do?
Oh, Alanwe, no.
What did you get? Did you dodge?
How do you do the dodge?
You just roll one?
Yeah, roll a d20, and you just want to roll under your dodge, which is 8.
It was Alanwe. It's not Alanwe, right? Alanwe?
8 or less.
Yeah, it's just Alanwe.
Yeah. Alanwe dodges as well.
Do you have any more...
I do have a fate point. I'm going to go and spend my... I have 2 left fate points left. I'm going to go and spend it to roll again. I mean, it's a long shot.
Because you're at minus 5. Hey, Ben, you are at minus 3 because it's your second dodge before you've had to go, got to go again.
Okay, so I'm at my... Oh, crap. I got a 4 or lower. I'm not going to get this. Yeah, no, I missed that one too, so... Okay.
Vigalos, blinded in one eye, staggering in pain, unable to yet go, one of these squirrels leaps down and catches you on the back of your calf for 8 points.
Sorry, we were having a little discussion. Could you say that last bit one more time?
Vigalos, so it lands on you. You feel a searing pain in your right calf as one of these squirrels spears you for 8 points of damage.
Oh, wow. All right.
Are you at five or less?
I am exactly at five.
Then you are unconscious unless you spend a fate point.
You know what? I'm going to spend my last fate point to stay awake.
Alanwe, it is your turn. And then it is Vigalos's turn.
It rolls off him.
Do you guys have any kind of, like, dispel or...
Like, just, like...
I think there might be magical horns.
Well, obviously, but... No.
What good are you magic people?
I've often wondered that same question.
Who has... The one has my eye!
Vigalos, come
here. If you guys could get that back, maybe...
Alanwe, are you moving, are you staying, or are you fighting the squirrels?
I think I'm going to fight the squirrels and help Vigalos get out of here.
Okay.
So I'm going to maybe do... Is there a defense action type thing? Like, to defend somebody?
Holy crap.
Not really.
Oh, cool. Okay, I'm going to do the spell Acceleratus.
Acceleratus? Who are you doing it on?
Wait, can I do it on somebody else?
It says target category living creatures. So any one of us that you touch.
So I can make them faster?
Yeah, you can make them faster.
Don't get the squirrels! Please!
I don't know that it's going to help him a whole lot at this point. Like, he's got a huge, like a negative four or something.
Yeah, no, I'm...
So yeah.
You can do it on yourself, you do it on one of us. It's all fine.
Gives you one plus defense. And
double movement and double initiative.
Right. So would that help him at all?
Double my initiative. I got a four on my initiative. So
four total?
Four.
D6 plus?
Plus 18, so I got 18 on my initiative.
Okay. Alright, so that's a pretty good initiative, actually.
But minus four, so 14 initiative. Right. So it wouldn't really... I guess it might move me up a bit.
You'd be faster.
I would be faster. Run. But I am also...
I think cast on him and let him run the heck out of here.
Okay.
That's...
Vigalos, you get to act as normal this round because you spent a fate point.
Okay.
It should be all right. Acceleratus. What's the sagacity is 10, so that's fine. Intuition is 15, so that's fine. And your 4 is fine, so you're good. So you got a 4, so you got a quality level 1 or 2. Quality level 2.
2. Right. So I touch him and I guess say words. How does that work?
Elves sing their magic.
Oh, I sing. Go ahead.
All right, Vigalos, you find yourself faster, and it is your turn.
This is a new experience for Vigalos.
Sorry. Are you getting out of there?
Yes. Vigalos is stumbling since he has one leg basically crippled and only one eye.
Can Delilah help him?
Sure. But he's way faster than you now. Okay. Like,
moving like 16 yards a turn.
Well, he's also fat and slow, so
it's
right. Less than that.
Still a lot.
Yes, Delilah, back around to the top. Let's actually do Takani and Thorwolf. You are up first.
All right.
Thorwolf.
At this point, Thorwolf is, I think, you can tell me, but I think probably he's had enough of these shenanigans, and... you know, this is not the great death in battle that he came seeking. Yeah. So he's just going to swing at another one of these little guys with his orc nose and hit.
It fails to dodge. And Thorwolf manages to kill another one of these death squirrels. You can hear, as each of them die, they let out a high-pitched whine and you can see more of the shadows in the trees start to gather.
As each one dies, more gather?
You can see...
Like those soldier ants, you step on one, it puts out a pheromone that calls all the others.
Takani, you're up. And then Vigalos and Delilah.
No, it won't work. Never mind, it won't work.
When I killed that one, did the, like... You said the horn turned into powder. Did it smell like anything? Did it smell like it's making, like... Is it a magic thing that's calling more?
You don't know. Would you like to take a... Would you like to take a action to give me an animal lore and see what you know about?
Oh, but... I don't know if I should fight or get out of here.
You should get out of here.
I would get out of there.
Remember that scene in Willy Wonka?
I would. I mean, I did.
No?
The new one. The horrible new one with Johnny Depp.
No one saw that.
Oh, okay. There's a scene with squirrels. This also works for Squirrel Girl. We do know this.
Yes.
Okay. Even Thanos has been taken down by a horde of squirrels.
Apparently, this is the only thing Thanos and Wigolas have in common.
That's right.
Okay, I guess I'm... running, okay?
We should all keep...
You can take a swing as you're running if you would like, Takani.
Yeah,
yes.
You have 8 movement. It's the same movement whether or not you attack.
Yep.
I'm assuming there's no dash action, so...
No.
Okay, I hit if he doesn't dodge.
It looks like your saber is about to cut this death squirrel in half, and it drops all the way to the ground, dodging the blow.
Aww.
Delilah, as you and Vigalos round the path, you can see up ahead a large pond that has a waterfall flowing into it. It's the sound that you heard earlier.
I think of the water.
Delilah's also being very careful to stay on the path and not let it, like, push her some other place. Just saying that. Because...
No, that's fair. At this point, you can see that the mist has rolled back away from the edge of the lake, and you can clearly see where the path curves around the lake.
Okay. So, I guess we keep following the path.
Probably the witch wouldn't appreciate it if I just set everything on fire right now.
Magical forest. Who knows what might happen.
Yeah. All right, I won't do that.
Delilah and Vigalos, as you continue to move around, you do see that there is a rather stately woman who seems to be gathering herbs from the edge of the... The pond. She also kind of looks up as you can hear. I mean, Vigalos is not doing, I'm assuming, anything to be quiet at this point.
No! It hurts!
When you say she's stately, like on a scale of like Kate Blanchett to Meryl Streep, like what are we talking about?
I'd put her definitely in the Kate Blanchett. I like your scale. I don't really feel like it's a continuum, as it is just 2 points, but that's fair.
It is 2 points. It is 2 points. But there are ways in which you could describe both of those people as saintly, so I was just trying to get...
Cool.
Awesome.
Tristan, and then the Death Squirrels.
Right. So Tristan has been, cast a spell and running. So how far away are the Death Squirrels from me at this point?
They're about 10 yards away. You've made some good distance. Some of them seem to be congregating where Vigalos's wounding happened.
And Ellenway and Connie,
they're in the thick of it.
They're in the thick of it right
now. Well, Ellenway definitely is, because she used her action to...
Yeah, to spell. And how many Death Squirrels are there on the ground at this point?
There are about 9. You can see that they're starting to get back to the tree and try to scamper back up.
See, this is where like just like a good area of effect spell would just be awesome. Okay.
Cone of cold.
Yes, cone of cold, or just sleep.
Spray. Magic missile.
Yeah, basically anything. All right. I'm going to... Tristan is going to shout to the others, "Everyone, run!" And I'm going to run. That's what I'm doing.
All right. Alanway, At this point, you see the squirrels scampering back up into the trees.
I'm running.
All right. Very quickly, almost out of nowhere, you round the corner, a bend in the path, and there is Vigalos and Delilah, the lake kind of spread before you. Behind you, you do hear the chittering of the squirrels, but they do seem further off.
Cheering?
Chittering.
Cheering or...
Chittering.
Chittering. Yeah, that changed tone slightly.
Yeah, not cheering. The maniacal cackle of the death squirrels falls behind you.
All right.
And you find yourself on the shore of this woodland lake.
Is Tristan there as well now?
Yep, you are all there.
All right.
As you were running, it looked like you were heading deeper into the forest, and you rounded this large tree, and suddenly, this lake.
In that case, Thorolf will have come behind too with his shield over his head.
I have some four-leaf singleberry. That's a healing thing, right? That I found.
It is, but it doesn't work instantly. But I do have some things that I can do to attend to our friend here. I believe we've also found the witch. Yep. So we've got to prioritize here.
Okay. She looks up as Tristan says that, and her voice rings clearly across the lake. You have found a witch.
The witch!
Are there more of you here?
Also, is there a baby?
My friend is delirious from pain.
Is there a baby?
If you would please just give us a few moments to tend to his wounds, we mean you no harm.
Very well.
I'm not sure we'd harm you anyway if we wanted to, so.
The wise.
Away.
Very well. See to your friend.
All right. You probably can't cast spells on yourself. So...
I don't think I could... Yeah.
I'm going to give you... I'm going to, first of all, give you one of these healing potions, which I think recovers d6 plus 2 hit points.
Okay.
So I will...
This is... freaking valuable, so.
I have that too.
Okay.
But one of us can use it depending on. Yeah.
So who rolls the healing? Me?
Yeah, you can roll it. Okay. So I'll just pull out the small glass bottle and pop the cork and say, first of all, take this and pour it down his throat.
Don't chew.
So 6.
Right. It tastes of singleberry. All right, at 11, so that you're still out of pain, right?
I think that brings me up to half pain, though.
Okay.
Because not quite 3/4.
All right. And then, did you want to...
Yes, I have a healing spell.
Okay. While she uses her healing spell, I'm going to lay a hand on him as well and mutter under my breath as I'm very focused on casting... No, I'm not going to do that again.
Brain doesn't like it when he uses bad words, Tristan.
I'm sorry, what?
You're muttering into your breath. He assumed it was bad words.
It's in Boraxi. It's a boss form, rather. It's a spell.
Okay. Go on.
At this point, the woman kind of rises up from the side of the lake. Folds her the cloth that she was pulling the lakeside herbs into, ties it up, and just walks back towards the waterfall.
She's walking to the waterfall.
To the waterfall. She kind of, you can see she kind of heads behind it.
And she's on the opposite side of the
about a quarter of the way around the lake.
So for every A that you choose to spend, it heals him 1 life point.
Okay.
So,
I think so. We're trying to still get him patched up. Do you want to give? If you give him 7, he'll be at a whole lot better.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll do that.
Okay.
That's a lot, though. Thank you.
You're at 27.
Can I get AE back, by the way?
It comes back when you rest.
Oh, cool.
Like, yeah. Slowly, but it does.
Looking for dex, or?
Somehow we only have 2 pencils. All right. As we're magically healing Vigolas, I have a sneaking suspicion his eye does not just, like, regenerate.
That is correct.
Awesome.
Something has to get it back from the square.
Does the wound, like, start to close over a little bit, though?
Uh-huh.
And wounds by laying on hands.
Yeah, this is not going to replace an eyeball, though. That was because of his crit fail.
I don't have an extra one.
Vigolas, take it from me.
Fine.
The ladies love a scar.
Okay.
Does Tristan have a scar?
Scars.
From, like, Tristan.
No, I sort of.
Do you have any scars, Tristan?
I imagine Tristan actually has a couple of scars on his face because the Midden Realms are so similar to Germany, where since the Middle Ages, Messersword fighting has been a thing in colleges and universities, such as the one which Tristan attended.
All right.
So I assume he has a couple of dueling scars, essentially.
Fair enough.
And traces from the
No, don't do that. I will break your fingers.
Okay.
Thorwolf, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm
I've
fine.
Never seen anything like
it's
that.
Just, there's been never had squirrels jump out of trees at me before.
No, this we're
there
all...
was this one time on the ocean when time for.
Can somebody tell me if the squirrels had tufts on their ears?
They did. I think they did.
Okay, then that is definitely a greater northern squirrel.
Only the females, though.
How could you tell?
Exactly. No.
Maybe you should have been running more.
Delilah, while all of this is going on, and Takani and Delilah, what are you doing while Alanwe and Tristan are healing Vigolas?
I'm watching to see where the lady went.
Did I?
She went to the waterfall.
Yeah, she went behind the waterfall.
Didn't.
Is it like a thing we can follow, or did she kind of like magic away?
No. She just you can see the footprints in the sand.
Then, where she carried me?
I think.
Sorry.
Awesome.
Okay, I don't think I'm doing anything helpful. I'm just standing around watching them. I probably picked up a dead squirrel for him. Yes,
Delilah,
I did that. I picked up a dead squirrel.
All right, you have a dead Delilah squirrel.
At the area where she was gathering herbs to see like what kind of herbs. Not that Delilah knows much about herbs, but...
You can give me a plant lore.
Sweet.
I have... Yeah. I have a lot of plants.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah,
here we go.
What's happening?
Two double 20s. Oh.
Critical.
Let's see. That was like really bad.
You heard from this plumber this one time that those red and white mushrooms are really good for you.
So good. Totally believe that plumber.
Okay, so she failed on
their plan.
SGC, sagacity.
Yes.
Sagacity and dexterity.
Both
of them critical
lore.
Fails. Like 20. Very badly failed.
Man, I can't wait to see how you narrate this one.
Critical fail on a plant lore. Double.
Critical fail on a plant lore in a magical wood.
Itch the bush in your face.
You now have hive.
Poison ivy.
For your skin.
All
right. Back when I grew up, we used this stuff for wiping paper.
No, don't
help. Sorry. Hey, all right, I got this. Delilah, you, as you kind of look through the rushes and you look through the plants, you definitely see a plant that you recognize. I'm looking for the name of it right now. It's a small brownish sort of mushroom that is growing on the underside of a log that is laid, that has kind of fallen into the a shallow end of the lake that is kind of a little stagnant. It's grayish brown and has off-white lamellas and little purple spots that seem to glow a little blue.
It's probably fine.
It's glowing.
Does it glow?
Can I recognize it? Just a little bit.
Okay.
There's only about 3 or 4 small mushrooms.
So what do I recognize it from?
Oh, it's they were sautéed in a thick gravy.
Defeat to your enemy.
From your youth.
Oh.
Your aunt and your mother would sauté them for you. You didn't expect to find them awesome. So far north.
That's amazing. I didn't know. I found something. This is great. So she's going to pick all three of them.
You have all three of them.
Pull them out from under. Yeah.
All right.
And put them in my bag.
She's going to poison us all. Accidentally.
No, I grew up with this.
And that is how we die, except for Wigolas, who died with a squirrel through his face.
Squirrels and the mushrooms.
Squirrels and mushrooms. All right.
Well, I'm going to use my really high cooking skill on this. We're not eating right.
Wigolas thankfully has more than half his health back, so he stumbles to his feet and...
Ben, you will have the restricted sense sight disadvantage from here on out with no AP benefit from it.
Dang.
Okay.
All right. We can ask you, will you be all right?
I think so.
The eye patch will look very rakish. Okay. I think it'll go along well with the country. So.
If you say so, Tristan.
Very, very, very thug-like, Gareth.
Original Gareth? OG?
Yes. OG, indeed. So, let's...
I love you guys. Just gonna toss that out.
I don't even know what happened.
The original Gareth, the OG, that's so good. Tristan is gonna say that from now on because he thinks it's a thing. Alright, we'll follow the witch, I suppose.
Yep.
All right, as you move around the lake, the silver beams of moonlight kind of ripple along the lake surface, and as you round the edge, you do see a small cave behind the waterfall. Inside is a roaring fire, a rocking chair, and what seems to be a very cozy home. This woman is grinding the herbs up with a mortar and pestle. You're either very wise, or very brave, or very foolish to enter the wildwood. Seeing as you were attacked by death squirrels, going to go
yes.
with a second.
No.
Wait, what did you call him that?
What, really? What did you say?
And you went to what school?
It's a joke to call it Tagani.
Oh.
I'm trying to break the ice.
Good job.
What are you doing in my woods?
My name is Tristan Foxer. I am a white mage. And these are my friends. Yes. I'm Delilah the Dancer. Wigolas, a blessed one of Perrain. Tikani, a friend of mine, Ellen Way, she's of the Glade Elf folk, and Thorwulf here, another friend of mine. And we are here to speak with you
about a man named Oakward.
Oakward.
You were married to him at one time.
No, that's not.
No.
Just rest. Just rest.
I remember. Young fellow, yes? Wanted to be a butcher of some sort.
A bone setter, and he was young until he left you.
Well, he was young when he left me.
I think it was about 20 years ago.
It was... Please, we go ask. He tells us that he was aged 20 years when he left.
It is possible.
He blames, rightly or wrongly, I do not make any judgment, but he holds you responsible for the time that he lost.
He holds me responsible for the time that he lost. That is a very linear way of looking at it. And why would he send you here? Does he believe I can give him his years back? Does he believe you could force me to give him his years back? She stops grinding the mortar and the pestle.
He sent us to ask if you could return them.
I suppose.
Is that just impossible?
Oh. Not with me, but perhaps with the one who actually stole his ears, yes. But there are threads that were pulled that night. If you pull at one of them again, the whole thing may unravel.
Do you mean the orc raid?
Is this metaphorical threads?
I do remember the Oakward raid, among other things. Very well, come inside. Touch nothing. Don't bleed in my cave. She looks right at Vigalos.
Okay.
She sets the mortar and the pestle down, tastes a little bit of what she was grinding, nods, and moves it over and sets it on a shelf next to a large collection of glass vials and blown glass orbs and long-throated vases. Tell me, why did he believe that I stole his ears?
He didn't... I think part of the difficulty that we're operating under here is that he believed that there was but one Witch of the Wood, and it appears that there may be more than one?
Indeed.
Well, then if you're not the one, then I don't think anyone believes you did it, but we would like to talk to the woman who did. If she did.
She is not, but I can send you to her, but you will not find her nearly as pleasant company as myself. My mother, Anshela, is...
What can you tell her? Tell us about her.
What was her name?
Anshela.
Anshela, and your name was?
Ephra.
Ephra.
My mother does not approve of... my methods. Or... my magics. You notice that at this point, three cats kind of walk in. They rub against the legs of all of you as they make their way towards Ephra.
Are you good kitties to eat squirrels?
One of them looks right at you, Wigalos, right in the eye, and gives you the look of the cat that ate the canary. gives you this, this broad feline grin, and then goes back to nuzzling Ephra.
Good kitties.
Your mother was the one who met with Oakwood.
She's the one who took his life. I'm the one who met with Oakwood.
I see.
Oh.
Can you... I know that there are always more than one side to every story. Could you tell me, could you tell us what happened?
Oh, it seems like it was only yesterday that the wood was alight with the promise of violence. Men and orcs fighting over something. And this young, strapping man comes to the shores of my lake, harried by death squirrels. It seems to be a reoccurring theme.
They're your death squirrels?
No. In fact, some would say that they're your mistress's death squirrels.
Oh. What? Yes.
I've lived my most of my life here in the woods, and Oakward was a man of subtle grace, and
difficult to imagine.
We spent the night together, and in the morning, I left and got involved with the orcs at the edge of the woods. It would not do to have Oakward and his friends slain. And so I may have lured the orc chieftain into the woods. I believe he still may be wandering around here somewhere. My mother was not happy with that.
Not!
For that, she cursed both myself and Oakward. And the results of that night.
The results? There was a baby?
She looks very pointedly at you, Takani. There was a child, yes.
Tristan reaches into his purse and hands a few coins to Vigolas.
That's really rude.
Yes.
She cocks her head and looks at you strangely.
He misunderstood, but oddly he was right. So, who's the baby?
I do not know. My mother took him from me. And that is the last we have spoken.
Him?
No. What?
Okay. What was the curse?
What was the curse?
And why should I tell you? I have shared much and you have shared little.
We're going to see your mother after this, obviously. Perhaps we can help you.
Because Oakwood sent us to get his life back. Now, if that same curse is upon you and upon a child, then we want to help you. We have shared little because there is little to share. I do not lie.
No, I can tell that. You wish to free Oakward. I wish to be free of my mother. Perhaps we can come to an accord.
a moment ago, you said that we would unravel something if we did that. Is that good?
That I do not know. What was intended 20 years ago on the part of the orc chief would then go back into play. I do not know what he sought or what he searches for still. I see his shadow every once in a while beyond the trees.
So he would be freed.
Perhaps.
Spoke of an agreement. What would you ask of us?
Anshela keeps that which she steals in crystal vials in her home deeper in the woods. I can give you a spell that will guide you to Oakwards and my own. And perhaps some aid should you need it. In return, I wish to be free. My mother's magic has kept me bound here for 20 years, to this lakeside, no more than 30 yards around it. My mother's magic binds me here. I think it is time for a new Witch of the Woods, don't you?
Tristan's got the magical lore skill.
Sure.
And while obviously I don't necessarily know all of the spells that are involved here, would he have any kind of an inkling, just like general mechanics of how enchantments work? Of what they're getting into, if there is a danger of, if they release whatever is in those vials, is it like a time machine? Does it undo everything that was done? Like, I'm...
Give like, me a magical lore roll.
Right.
And Delilah is listening to this and trying to determine if it sounds like she's telling us the truth, or
give
maybe
me an
there's
roll.
Something that she's...
That is a... That is a quality level 2, but it is also a critical success.
Excellent. All right, before I get to you, Alanwe and Takani, what are you doing while this is going on? Thorwulf is just sitting there, like, his eyes wide. He is rubbing his Fafnir tattoo on his wrist and muttering sailor's prayers.
Well, I'm going to play to my character because my character is superstitious. So she's not touching anything. She's standing far away from all the glowy things, from all the herbs, from all the cats, from all everything, just not touching anything.
Thorwulf kind of reaches out and he's got a little wooden whale token on a string that he's been rubbing. He offers it to you.
I nod my thing and hand him the wooden wolf I made earlier.
All right. Cool. The two superstitious people are standing in the corner. Alanwe, what are you doing?
I'm just kind of observing everyone and everything and looking around the room.
Did you do empathy?
Yeah.
You can give me a perception roll as well. What did you get, Delilah?
Quality level 1.
Okay. So we're going to start with Tristan, and then we'll move back around. Oh, Vigalas, I apologize. I assume you are all right.
Vigalas is covering his eye and trying to get the cat to come.
Kitty, kitty.
The black one definitely moves right up to you.
He pets it.
It allows you to pet it for exactly 3 actions, and then a switch is flipped and it claws at you to let you know that it is done. I may not be able to convey half-orcs, but I know how to play cats. Tristan.
You just fucked up, half-orcs.
This is outside of the training that you have really received at the Gareth Academy of Sword and Staff. But you do know that certain rules exist. Satanov prevents any, because you got a critical success, Satanov is the one who pilots the Ship of Time. He prevents any sort of moving backwards or forward along that path. So unless these witches are engaged in magic far beyond your comprehension, what would most likely happen is these ears have been stolen and bound and will be released back out, not any sort of time travel of any sort.
Okay, so the chieftain, would he be released?
He wouldn't be released back in time. He would just be able to leave the woods at this point.
Okay, so it's not like the massive orc army that was here and then left would just like rematerialize. It would be a case of the orc chieftain would be freed and then he would get back to whatever agenda he was pursuing, presumably.
Exactly. Delilah, you were doing an empathy roll?
Yes.
That was actually...
What did you get?
Pretty useful.
Level 1.
Okay. Ephra, for all of her mask of calm and composure, there is anger roiling underneath as she talks about this. You feel it definitely spiked when she spoke about Oxford's ears being stolen. It definitely spiked when she said that Angela stole her child. And it also spiked when to this very vengeful note when she said there should be a new Witch of the Wood.
Okay.
If
Alanwe, what did you get on your perception roll?
Nothing.
The Not cats are very friendly, and two of them, while Vigalas is petting one of them, the other two are licking the blood off of his boot.
Yeah, that's gross.
Cats. If we do this, if we help you, if we find these two vials, and we get Oakwood's ears, and your curse lifted, then what happens? Will you go after your mother, or are you expecting us to go after her?
I don't suspect that my mother would allow someone to take her vials from her without a fight. And I am not allowed to leave but 30 yards beyond this lake.
And she has the boy?
I do not know what happened to the boy.
Delilah?
He will not look like either or his father.
What will he look like?
I do not know. But she swore that my meddling would be mingled with my joy.
Please. Okay, then.
I think rather than go back out, we should go and find her baby.
I don't think it's baby anymore.
Shh. There are always babies with their mothers.
All right. You said you would show us the way, and you said you might be able to offer help.
Indeed. I can tell you about my mother's protectors, though she is bound to her service. I can give you potions which will allow you to travel through the woods unimpeded by our magics for a time.
Also, will they repel the squirrels? Say yes.
Did you point at them? Did you make loud noises at them?
No. Yes, he did. They're very intriguing.
She holds out her arm like she's pointing at something, and then kind of brings that pointed finger back to her forehead. You challenged the death squirrels during mating season. That was not a very good or wise idea.
I think we've learned something for your book.
We have!
How valuable.
They're very jealous! Hats did not even...
It was your cattle. They were intimidated.
Perhaps, considering your friend's condition, it would be wise if you spent the rest of the night here. And in the morning...
I think...
We can plan our vengeance.
At dawn, we plan! Alright, who's good at treat wounds? I'm sort of good.
Legolas is good at treat wounds.
Well, you can't do yourself, I assume. Maybe you can.
So here's what we're going to do. We're going to do a little bit of bookkeeping. We will wrap up for the night. Ephra will treat wounds.
Oh, excellent!
Oh. You have eyeballs.
Yeah, do you have any extra eyeballs?
In any jars?
I don't think this is that sort of game.
I don't know!
Eyeballs in jars?
The Duke's house.
You all receive a +3 during your next regeneration phase.
Nice!
That would be cool if I had taken any damage.
Yep.
You have reached the end of the second act, so you all receive one fate point, and you will receive another fate point at the start of the next session.
So. Sweet!
I should have used one.
Yeah, I should have used more than one, but I don't know what I would have used it on. Alright, and then Grace, we can both roll a d6 to see how many astral points that we recover.
Arcane energy you receive back, yep.
Arcane energy, I don't... Apparently it's something else in a German version of the game, and I was talking on the forums today, and they were calling them, like, astral points or whatever, and I was...
Is that what was going on in our conversation? Because you lost me there for a little bit. When I was reading through what you were posting... When I was reading through what you were posting, I was like,
When you were chatting with Marcus, or...
Well, I mean, I sent JM a bunch of the stuff that is supposed to be coming for
the neighbors. Gotcha.
So anyway.
And Tristan, yeah. Do not forget, you did get that ring from
the Total Effects. I have not been forgetting that.
All right, everybody. Well, thank you so much for playing. I hope you had fun. I hope this was as eerie as I was hoping it was going to be.
It was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was really good.
Everyone, thanks for tuning in. And for those of you who are watching on YouTube, thank you for watching. We will see you in 2 weeks. We will be back on our normal schedule. So, all right. Good gaming.
Yes, bye.
Good night, everyone.
Bye. Bye.